In this course, we will discuss joint health and common injuries. Joints are one of the parts of the body we have covered in our previous human body courses. If you have yet to complete the previous classes, please review them before continuing with this course. First, let's review the anatomy of joints. Joints are where two or more bones meet. The two most common types of synovial joints are the hinge and the ball and socket. These types of joints allow for the greatest amount of movement. Within the joint, there is cartilage and synovial fluid, which help the bones move smoothly. Cartilage is the smooth padding found on the ends of long bones. Ligaments are band-like connective tissue that holds bones together. Cartilage found on the ends of long bones is called hyaline cartilage and allows bones to move smoothly. Cartilage in the knee joint is highlighted in blue in the picture on the right. In ball and socket joints, another type of cartilage, known as fibrocartilage, acts to hold the bones together to prevent joint dislocation. Fibrocartilage in the knee, also known as the meniscus, acts as a shock absorber for jumping and landing. Ligaments are band-like connective tissue that hold bones together. Ligaments help bones stay in proper alignment and provide strength and stability to the joint. Ligaments of the knee joint are highlighted in blue in the picture on the right. Ligaments prevent bones from moving beyond the joint's normal range of motion to prevent injury. One of the most commonly injured ligaments is the anterior cruciate ligament, or ACL. The ACL is found behind the patella, or kneecap, and prevents leg bones from moving into an unsafe position. Joint health is important in order to remain active as you age. You can protect joint health by maintaining a healthy weight through diet and exercise. Physical activity helps replenish the synovial fluid found in joints to keep things moving smoothly. On the other side, poor posture can put unnecessary strain on joints, leading to damage over time. Likewise, a sedentary or inactive lifestyle will lead to joint stiffness, limiting the joint's natural range of motion. Exercise plays an important role in joint health, but it is equally important to exercise with proper technique. By maintaining alignment and stabilizing parts of the body that are not involved in the movement, you can prevent injuries to joints. Building strong muscles and bones will help to strengthen joints and protect their structure. After exercise, it is important to stretch in order to maintain the joint's range of motion. Beware of overtraining, which can cause long-term damage to joints. Know your limits and take appropriate rest breaks between workouts. We will examine four common types of joint injuries in this course. The first is arthritis. Arthritis is a condition that builds over time. Dysfunctional movement and joint injuries can cause damage to cartilage and contribute to the development of arthritis. The signs and symptoms of arthritis include pain, stiffness, and redness around the affected joints. Arthritis can affect any joint and makes exercise and everyday activities painful. Another type of joint injury, known as a ligament sprain, is the result of an overstretched ligament. This type of injury is typically caused by dysfunctional movement or movement outside a joint's normal range of motion. The signs and symptoms of a ligament sprain include pain, swelling, and limited range of motion. By stretching out the ligament, this type of injury actually weakens the joint and increases the risk of future joint injuries. A ligament tear is a more severe ligament sprain. In this case, the ligament is torn or completely separated from the bone. This type of injury is also the result of movement outside the joint's normal range of motion. The signs and symptoms of a ligament tear include pain, swelling, bruising or discoloration, and limited range of motion. While a ligament sprain may heal on its own with ice and rest, a ligament tear may require medical attention in order to heal properly. A joint dislocation is the complete separation of the bones in a joint. This type of injury may be caused by a sudden impact, a fall, or forceful twist of a joint. The signs and symptoms of a dislocation include a visible deformity of the joint, instability, and pain. When the bones separate, they may cause damage to surrounding tissues, such as ligaments, tendons, and cartilage. Joint dislocation requires medical attention to ensure that the joint is properly realigned.